do you know, I'm looking forward to cooling down because it's so hot. But I'm very much looking forward to it. It's a huge honour to be nominated and to be in such eminent company.
Apart from yourself, obviously, who have you got your fingers crossed for tonight?
Oh, do you know, I really think the nomination is the biggie. Getting nominated is fantastic. So it's whoever wins whichever category will just be icing on the cake. I mean, I don't know. I didn't name a name. hopefully, it's a good show, and I think Sky is part of Sky's slate of brilliant programmes. I'm a big fan of Stella, obviously, but I think that Sky are producing really, really good stuff at the moment, and they're really going for it. They're getting a broad spectrum of settings, locations. They're going all around the country with Starlings being up in Nottinghamshire, and the cafe being down in Weston-super-Mare. I think they're doing brilliantly. So I think it's really lovely for Sky. They've got a few nominations actually tonight. So I'm really chuffed for them.
Doing very well for themselves. Sky keeping busy as always. Talking about yourself, what have you got coming up?
We're currently making a second series of Stella. Yeah, so we're in the middle of that. So it's a very fleeting visit to London, and then I'm back, leaving at 5 tomorrow morning, getting back on set. So.
Fans will want to know, what are they going to get from the second season they didn't from the first?
A continuation of a great story, I hope. Yeah, and lots more of our characters who I really love and I'm looking forward to seeing on screen. It's really nice when we're filming at the moment and just sort of meeting characters like Daddy and Bobby again I feel like I really know them, like they're real people.
Fans love all of these characters. Do you have a favourite, to work with or just to watch?
Do you know, I really do love them all, and especially when I'm like writing for them, I just really, it's such a joy to be able to write them. But and even like the little characters, like the character called Lisa Howells, who's in the first episode, who sings by the coffin. You know, there's so many. There aren't any little characters for me. They all mean something.
The show is packed with so much originality and creativity. I mean, where do you take all the inspiration for these kind of characters?
I get a lot of stories from people I know. People tell me things that happen to them, and so I steal them. I steal them unashamedly and put them into the script. And sometimes I'll say to people when they say a line, I go, "That's going in." So it's just from day to day, from real life.
People might be a little shocked that some of the things they see on screen have been borrowed. What do you think would surprise people the most, that it actually happened, it was actually set?
Well, there was a lot of comment about the horse in the house, but that genuinely came from somebody I know who had a friend who was a doctor who did a house visit, and there was a horse in the house. So I thought, well, it has happened, so it can legitimately go in.
Speaking of going in, we're going to let you get inside and cool
Thank
off.
You. Final.
Well, you're looking hot, but in a good way,
in a good way.
Final question, do you have a message to fans, anything you'd like to say to them?
Well, thank you for watching Stella. I'm really glad that you all like it so much, and I hope you enjoy the second series. And more than that, I hope you enjoy the BAFTA show tonight. It should be good fun as usual.